The world is a vampire. Sent to drain. Secret destroyers.
How's it going today, my YouTubians, ODZians, Slayansayans, Cobra Kais, and my pumpkins that are smashing? I am Asherella the Original, and this is my channel, Original Asherella. Today's video, we are going to be looking at and responding to an article that documents and breaks down how the newly named King Charles, formerly Prince Charles, Prince of Wales, is a direct descendant of the Transylvanian royalty, Vlad the Impaler, also known as Vlad Dracula, also known as the inspiration for Bram Stoker's Dracula, which has so much to do with the vampire lore that we know and love today. So of course this article piques my interest, and I'm really excited to look at it with you guys and share all my thoughts and feels on it, and I'm going to get into that in just one second. But before I do, if you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. If you're watching on Odyssey, follow the channel. You can leave me a like, you can leave me a comment, you can gently press the notification bell on either platform so you know every time I upload a video. So gently caress, follow me on the things, the Insta thing and the Twitter thing.
Can you fake it for just one more show?
Okay, who else is very excited to find out how King Charles is related to Dracula? In my personal opinion, I've always found Charles to be a little dweeby, a little uncool. And I will say that this kind of ups his Kool-Aid just a skosh. But, you know, I am an American, so any Brits that are watching right now, how do you guys feel about Charles, and what's your just general opinion of him? Let me know that in the comments. No offense to my Brits, though. And this article is from Cornwall Live, and the title is King Charles III is a descendant of Dracula and owns properties in Transylvania.
The royal family has links to several countries across Europe, including Romania, and it turns out that King Charles is the descendant of the real-life Dracula, formerly known as Prince Charles, Prince of Wales. Charles III actually owns several properties in Transylvania. Is the heir to Vlad the Impaler's bloodline.
See, that definitely ups your Kool-Aid, at least a skosh, right? I mean, I think so.
The ruthless prince, also known as Vlad Tempest and Vlad the Third Dracula, is known for his cruelty toward the enemies and impaling them on stake. He lived in the 15th century and is said to have inspired Bram Stoker for his famous Count Dracula. In 1462, following a battle, Vlad left a field filled with thousands of impaled victims. More than 530 years later, in 1998, King Charles found out about his links to the Romanian ruler. He is, in fact, his great-great-grandson, 16 times removed through the consort of George V, Queen Mary. A genealogical tree in the British Chronicles, written by David Hughes, supports the claim. The website adds, it's also no secret that Prince Charles is very fond of Romania, especially the Transylvania region. It was after his first visit to Transylvania in 1998 that he found out about his connection to Vlad the Impaler, a connection that he is apparently very proud of.
I mean, come on, if you found out you were like the great-grandson 16 times removed of somebody so like infamous and famous, and yes, I mean, impaling people, not good, but it was all in war and it was all for a cause, right? Anyway, like I said, Kool-Aid up a little ever so slightly.
Through the Prince of Wales Foundation, Prince Charles has done plenty of charity work in Transylvania, especially in the fields of sustainable development, conservation, and farming systems. Because of his strong involvement in the region, the mayor of the city of Alba, Luelia, has proposed to grant Prince Charles the title of Prince of Transylvania as recognition for being a prominent ambassador of the Transylvania region all over the world.
I think that's pretty cool. How do I get to be, like, the princess of Transylvania? Can I be a countess of Transylvania? How many, like, YouTube subscribers would it take to get that? I don't know.
Okay. So, the great-great-grandmother of King Charles' late mother, Queen Elizabeth II, Hungarian Countess Claudia Reddy, was also born and raised in Transylvania in the 19th century. King Charles now owns several properties in the Romanian region in Visiri and the Zalan the Lanulu Valley in Malincrav and in Breb. The tiny hamlet of Zalanon Valley was the first documented in the 16th century as belonging to Balint Kalnaki, one of the Transylvanian ancestors of HRH, the Prince of Wales. The family had originally founded a glass factory as part of the hills, which has since ceased to exist. Today, around 120 inhabitants live in the village. Prince Charles owns the property that has been built for the former judge who was overseeing glassworks in the village. It is composed of several buildings and has a patch of forest and extensive flower meadows with mineral springs and small brooks belonging to it. The properties are now holiday cottages and can be booked by tourists.
Okay, so we know that King Charles is the 16th great-grandson, sorry, base, of Count Dracula. Like, that is kind of cool. I think so, at least. You know, I love this type of stuff. It's like, you know, right up my alley. So I just wanted to share this little bit of vampire history with you guys. Or actually, it's not even history. It's vampire current events with you guys. What do you think about King Charles and his, you know, relation to Dracula? Do you love Bram Stoker's Dracula? Have you ever read the book? If you haven't, have you seen the film? It's actually a great movie adaptation. One of my favorites, definitely. Let's talk about Bram Stoker, Prince Charles, and the real Vlad the Impaler, and anything else you want to talk about down in the comments below. That is it for today, guys. I am Astrella, the first and the original. This is my channel, Original Astrella. If you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. If you're watching on Odyssey, follow the channel. If you're watching on YouTube but you have an Odyssey account, go find me on Odyssey. The link will be down in the description. Leave me a like, leave me a comment, gently press the notification bell so you know every time I upload a video. Follow me on the things. I have the Insta thing, I have the Twitter thing. Always tap in, never tap out, and don't forget to keep on playing like a fan.
Despite all my rage, I am still just a rat in a cage. Despite all my rage, I am still just a rat in a cage. And someone will say, what is lost can never be saved. Despite